wondering, do you think I hurt Medissa saying that stuff to her back there?
I suppose you might have. But I was thinking the exact same things you were. Losing a mother. It's always a tragedy. I'm glad you stepped in and stopped her.
Thanks.
That Eleanor, I swear, she feels way more responsibility for everything than she needs to. You think we need to worry? What if she pushes too far and erupts with malevolence?
Malevolence is born out of many things. A prideful ego. The self-righteousness that turns a blind eye to one's inner contradictions. Eleanor is different. She's mindful of her ego and strives to confront her inconsistencies of character.
She has a purity of heart that won't be tainted by the emotions that create malevolence. No other quality is as essential for an exorcist.
So she's probably okay?
For now, at least. But human hearts can be fickle things. Who knows what the future holds?
I doubt you got anything to worry about. For most exorcists, purity is a construct of the Abbey's teachings. But Eleanor, she's the real deal.
She's not your average exorcist, I'll give you that.
Purity is handy for any exorcist. But more than that, it's a rare and precious temperament for living. Everybody's got an ego and certain internal contradictions to some degree. Facing one's own ugliness in an honest manner is never easy. To be a normal human is to live carrying malevolence. It's just how much you let it control you that varies.
I guess malevolence might just be a fact of life, huh? But Artorias can't accept that.
Well, I don't see anything out of the ordinary.
Let's slip through town and head for Titania before that changes. So this is your secret hideout. Once I get free, you won't stand a chance. You all had better sleep with one eye open. Look how worried I am. She's the same age as Diana. Did the Abbey really turn someone so young into a Therian?
Eleanor!
Medissa, please, would you be able to talk to her? Is this a trick? Kamalana may be a Therian, but deep down, she's still a normal little girl who misses her mother. I can't do anything to console her, no matter what I try. But if it were you... You okay? You can call me Medissa, all right? Do I scare you, honey?
A little, but not as much as Velvet and Dial. Don't you think I'm scary? I had a bad dream earlier. My mommy said I looked scary and that she didn't want me anymore.
She would never. Your mother would never think that about her daughter.
But how do you know?
Because I'm a mother too. Mothers always love their children, no matter what. No matter if we die. No matter how the world changes. There's nobody who loves you more in the world than...
It's okay. You don't have to cry. I hope Kamalana and Medissa won't have to feel so lonely anymore.
Yeah. Trying to stop the waterworks gets old fast.
Listen, if it's not too personal... Was your mother,
She's dead. I lost her when I was even younger than you.
Oh. I'm sorry to hear that.
It's fine. It just means we've got things in common. So no feeling sad and alone, okay?
Oh, no. I'm fine. I don't feel lonely or anything. I swear.
What's gotten into you? You're so strange sometimes.
No, I'm not.
Eleanor, I'll have you watch over Kamalana and Medissa.
Yes, of course. I'd be honored. Thank you.
Are exorcists supposed to be so polite to a grand poobah of calamity or whatever?
Sure, why not? Besides, the Demon Lord ought to not trouble herself over such trivialities.
Velvet, Grimoire's calling for you. She says to bring Lafayette and meet her at the observation tower.
Got it.
We better get going, then. Hey, do you all have mothers?
Where'd that question come from?
Well, after hearing that Velvet, Kamawana, and Eleanor all lost their parents, I just got curious.
My mother was a strict, frightening woman, but she died a long time ago.
I see.
I have no parents either, but the Wicked Witch who took me in said I was born from a peach that floated down the river.
Coming from you, I'd almost believe that.
And you, Aizen?
We Malakim are formed from untainted mana. Sometimes humans are reborn as Malakim, but they retain no memory of their previous lives. In other words, we don't have blood relations like humans do.
I see. By the time I was aware of anything around me, I was already tethered and being called number two. I suppose having no mother means I don't have any memories before that. I told Medissa that losing a mother is painful, but I can't know how painful it is.
Go easy on him, Aizen. He's just a kid.
I'm just telling it like it is. But listen to me, Lafayette. You can share deep connections with other people, even if you don't have a biological family. Malakim, too, can form precious bonds, true friendships, even family.
That's right. Your words wouldn't have stopped Medissa if they weren't true in your heart.
You really think so?
I'm sure of it.
It's far better than being a witch born from a peach.
Nonsense! There's no nobler way to be born! I have an everlasting friendship with a dog, a monkey, a pheasant, and Bienfu.
I hope he's right.
You said that Malakim can have familial ties, but what makes you and your sister siblings if you're not related by blood?
Well, a very long time ago, I was born into this world from an earth pulse point up on a sacred mountain. I remained in that place for a long while, and then one day, she was born from the very same earth pulse point. Before we knew it, we had wound up living together under the same roof.
Are two Malakim always siblings if they come from the same Earth Pulse point?
No. Other Malakim were born there, but I never felt like they were my family. But something, and I don't know what, was different with her. If she was sad, I'd feel sad. And if I was happy, she'd be happy too. She can be abrasive, but when she smiles, it's like nothing else. I swore to myself that whatever happened, I would protect her. I made a pendant from a stone on that sacred mountain and gave it to her as a lucky charm. Of course, she just wears it as a necklace.
And your pendant? Did she give that to you?
She had the same idea I had. She made the pendant herself and gave it to me as a good luck charm. Without either of us having mentioned a word of it beforehand, we each gave each other pendants in the same shape on the very same day. That's when I really knew that what I had felt all along was true. We were brother and sister.
Is that her in the picture?
Yeah. It's a self-portrait she drew for me on the day I left home.
Did you draw her a picture of yourself?
No. I don't exactly have an artistic side.
Well, I'm sure that if you looked inside her pendant, you'd find a portrait of the person who matters most to her.
I hope so.
Yeah, and it would be nice if it was you.
Thank you.
there you two are.
Hi, teacher. Have you made progress deciphering the book?
I have indeed. It turns out there was a second counting song. I've already transcribed it. Would you read it aloud for us, child?
Okay. When the eight malevolences overflow, in the culmination of mankind's despair, Ennomenot will bring an end to all peoples and restore them to time immemorial. Four Empyreans shall wield a wrathful sword and cleave the great devourer, two asunder to sleep beneath the earth as scarlet moonlight illuminates the evil. The nameless Empyrean hath one heart. The nameless Empyrean hath one body.
Oh, yet more delightful material to keep us awake at night.
If I'm understanding this right, it's discussing the specific nature of Ennomenot? That's what I believe, yes. When the eight malevolences overflow in the culmination of mankind's despair, Ennomenot will bring an end to all peoples.
So, when the world is at peak malevolence, Ennomenot will use that power to bring an end to all. Is that it?
He's going to wipe out all of humanity?
Is that what the Abbey is after? Is that why they've been trying to bring back Ennomenot?
No. Artorias is not that kind of man. His two primary ideals are the many over one, and the restoration of order through will and reason. He sacrificed Lofi to protect this world, not to eradicate it.
You mean that's who he is as far as you know, yeah? People change, Velvet. Perhaps the Shepherd gave up hope. Maybe he lost faith in mankind. Fools prone to sin, endlessly generating malevolence.
He's not like that. If that's all true, then what point was there in Lofi's death?
Is there anything else in that book?
Yes and no. This copy itself is incomplete. There ought to be further pages, but they're missing. For now, I've done all I can.
There must be an original somewhere, right?
Without it, I doubt the Abbey would be plotting Ennomenot's revival. We can be sure they have complete understanding of their Empyrean's nature.
But this was the only copy in the Royal Villa. If the original is out there, who knows where it could be?
It's getting pretty late. Why don't we call it a day?
Yeah, let's get some rest.
Lady.
That's great.
She's gonna help me take a bath now. You should come join us too.
What? I couldn't.
It's okay. I don't mind at all. I...
Hey, Kamoana. Did you know? Dial started to grow a brand new tail. He's up at the observation tower.
Let's go see! Modessa, you too!
All right. But don't run, or you'll trip.
Appreciate it.
Having some girl trouble, my little Malik?
I'm just glad Kamoana and Medissa are starting to feel better.
Yeah, they both still have a long way to go, but it's such a relief to see them smiling.
We've got bigger things to worry about.
Hurry up and locate the next Earth Pulse point.
Right. Okay. Must you always be so blunt, Velvet?
I must, in fact. We're up against the Abbey here, and sooner or later they'll find this place.
That's true, but still.
Do we go find another hideout?
No, we'll keep on the offensive. We'll capture the remaining Therians before the Abbey finds us.
As a swordsman, I can respect that mindset.
I'm not so sure we could hold this place anyway.
We've got no obligation to.
I found another Earth Pulse point. It's in the eastern part of East Gand, I think.
But that's... All right. We're headed for East Gand.
Then our first stop should be Port Taliesin.
Grimoire always looks like she never wants to do any work, but despite all her grumbling, when she starts a job, she gets it done, and quickly, too. She's frank, but she still takes care not to say anything to hurt anyone's feelings. I have to say, I like that in a woman. It's charming.
Well, sorry if I'm inconsiderate and charmless, then.
I didn't mean it like that. You're all still so young and have led different lives. Can't fault you for being you.
Well, if you're saying we lack a certain air of maturity, I might not disagree.
That's for sure. It's true Lord Artorias has scolded my lack of composure at times.
Although I do get the impression that Grimoire has been dependable like that since she was young.
And it's a good impression at that. Old Grim's been that way since the day she was born. I hate to admit it, but her combination of insightful words and deadpan expression has charmed the hearts of many a Moloch. At her peak, she had a fan club 8,848 members strong, and her dinner shows would sell out the day the tickets went on sale. Molochim came by the droves to doze off listening to her live readings of ancient books.
Wow! I had no idea she was so popular!
Yeah, she's even a regular feature in Who's Who Among Norman.
Now that I think about it, I could see how a person could interpret her lethargy as patience, and her vague dispassion as maturity and poise. Compared to her, I'm just...
Were you just trying to imitate her?
No, I didn't mean to.
Whether you meant to or not, that kind of felt like her just now. I can see it in you, waiting to be awakened, that sophisticated charm.
Me? Sophisticated and charming? I don't know.
Try talking like her. You know how she lets her sentences trail off. This is your make-or-break moment here.
All right. I think I know what you mean. Here goes nothing. Oh... What do you think, Laffy said? Do I sound like her?
It feels a little off, but you're definitely doing it, I think.
You don't have to grow up, Madame Eleanor! You're cute just the way you are!
You stay out of this, Bianfu!
When mankind's despair reaches its pinnacle, Enominat shall reach out and bring an end to all.
So that song bothers you too?
No matter how many times I read it, I don't see any good in it.
Understanding that ancient tongue is difficult, right? Perhaps there's another interpretation? Maybe the end to all actually means an end to all human suffering, for example.
That is a possibility. But we're far too lacking in material to know anything for sure.
We need the other half of that book, or some other text on Enominat.
We don't have the time to search for it. Wouldn't even know where to start looking.
And don't forget that that book is just a copy. Whoever transcribed it might have made an error, too.
That's an unexpectedly sharp insight coming from you.
I'm an expert at errors. When Miss Mogilu made me copy magic tomes for her, I did it pretty half-heartedly.
Didn't that cause a lot of problems?
Well, when she tried to cast a spell from one of the tomes, the spell exploded in her face. It's really her own fault, though. She told me to copy 100 books in 3 days! That's impossible!
Oh, how cruel!
Cruel is right! That witch is a real devil, I tell you! A slave driver!
Bien Phu? Let's go somewhere a little more private, shall we?
Miss Mogilu!
Hush now. There's no need to worry. I'll make it a half-hearted punishment. Not that I really care, but who ended up winning the fishing competition when we were trying to catch a Therian?
Man, that was a while ago. I lost because I came away with nothing.
No, it was a draw. As I'm sure everyone remembers, all I fished up were octopus demons. We were competing over who would catch the Therian. Demons didn't count, so my score was 0-2.
No, the loss is mine, and I'm not giving it to you.
That's not just something you can up and decide like that. In fact, by fishing up those octopus demons, I put everyone in danger. That should count for negative points. I lost.
Who cares? It was all in fun.
I care. Every competition must have a winner and a loser, no matter what. That's just how I see it.
Yeah, I'm with Aizen on this one. It doesn't do anyone any good to make the final results murky.
I can't believe I'm going to do this. Aizen, your curse would mean that the odds were stacked against you from the start. That doesn't make for a fair competition, does it?
Yeah, she's got a good point. We'll just have to settle the score some other way.
What can you guys do? Play cards? Chess? What?
Cards are a no-go for me. I'll just end up drawing jokers.
And I can play shogi, but I don't know chess.
Then what about arm wrestling? Would that work?
Whoa, whoa! Having a demon and a Moloch clasp hands is just asking for trouble with malevolence.
You're both adults, so why not a drinking contest?
That's it! If we have a drinking contest, we'll be able to compete on an even playing field.
Yeah, I don't see anything wrong with that. I'll have the crew bring out the drinks.
Well, that's one way of resolving it, I suppose.
Whatever gets it done, I'm not gonna complain.
If you guys are gonna have a drinking contest, you're gonna need some tasty snacks to go with all that alcohol, right?
Definitely. Let's go out and fish us some snacks.
Yeah, let's take out the little boat. We can even pick up where we left off our fishing competition.
Didn't we just figure out he can't really fish?
Ugh, we were just about to finally resolve this mess. Why'd you have to go and stick your nose into it?
What? Why are you yelling at me? I didn't do anything wrong! Bien!
Hey, get this! I was out fishing the other day, when before I knew it, I'd wound up near a Class 4 island. Once I realized what was happening, I tried to turn the ship around, but then it got dark all around me.
Was it a sudden storm?
I wish! It was this great monstrous bird! damn thing had wings big enough to cover up the whole blasted sky!
That sounds like a bit of a stretch to me.
You think I'm lying? Then check it out for yourself. You just might not make it back alive.
A huge bird.
This island's really something. No way I'd want to go to prison here, but it'd make a great hideout. If I'm gonna be left in charge of this place, I'll turn it into the best hideout ever.
You're in charge?
Someone has to look after this place while you're all running around. Maintaining the ships in the base, watching the Prince and Medissa, keeping Kamuana company. I'll keep this place running shipshape, so that you all can focus on looking for the Therians.
But those are just odd jobs anyone can do. You're a navigator. Isn't that a waste of your talents?
You dolt! These are important tasks! Someone's gotta do it! We've got another navigator, but is there anyone besides me that could handle all of this by themselves? Besides, ever since I lost my tail, my balance has been off. The seasickness is killing me!
That's your story and you're sticking to it? Tell the truth. You don't want to come because you're afraid you'll be hurt again.
No. That's not it at all.
It's sour.
So you've kept your sense of taste.
In my dreams, I have. Nowhere else.
Does that make this a dream?
It would have to be, wouldn't it? After all. I devoured you.
That's right. Don't you go forgetting it.
How could I ever forget it? The taste of your... How could I ever... Looks like the fog's rolling in.
Yep.
Eleanor, there's something I want to be sure we get perfectly clear.
All right. What is it?
Lafayette is not your little Moloch.
What? That's all you wanted to say? You realize he doesn't belong to you either, right?
Indeed I do. Lafayette's his own person, and not anyone else's.
You're right. Malakim aren't just tools to be used by exorcists as they pleased. I'll be more careful not to forget that.
Good. As long as we're on the same page.
Since we're on the subject of reminders, you haven't forgotten our little bet, have you, Velvet?
You mean the 100 gold on whether I'd break? No, I haven't forgotten.
A word of caution. People can fight against pain, but they can't fight against happiness. If you're keen on winning our bet, I'd steer clear of ill-fitting dreams.
Sorry to break it to you, but all I have anymore are nightmares.
The fog's cleared. Good thing we didn't wind up getting lost in it.
Of course we didn't. Who do you think is running this ship?
A bunch of shameless rogues who are very good at shameless roguery.
Damn straight.
But it's strange. These waters don't usually see much fog.
Thank you.
It's like a castle.
This used to be the base of operations for a rich trading family. When trouble came knocking, they were ready for it, to say the least.
Wow! They must have had a lot of enemies.
But that was a long time ago. Nowadays, it's just another town in the middle of nowhere. But even so, to us, it was the big city of our dreams.
You know this area well.
I grew up near here. Keep on going, and you'll run into a ball. My home village.
Then, the Therian is...
Yeah, somewhere in my village.
Is that okay?
No one will know me there. Everyone I knew, I already devoured.
I just love the feel of the sun on my face. I'm glad the fog finally cleared up. For days, it was so thick, you couldn't see past your own nose.
We're lucky a demon didn't show up in all that fog.
Hmm? Niskan hasn't had much demon trouble to speak of. Didn't you know that? During the Advent, towns all across Eastgand were attacked by demons. It was Lord Artorias who saved us. Ever since, our towns have seen almost no demon attacks.
Is that true?
Oh, pardon me, Lady Exorcist. But if you're with the Abbey, surely you've heard about how things are here in Eastgand. Of course, demons are lurking about outside our towns. But for whatever reason, they don't attack us where we live.
That sounds unbelievable.
Everyone who visits us from abroad says the same thing. But this is neither joke nor lie. Everyone says that Lord Artorias's power lingers here, protecting our town against the demons. Whatever the reason, you're safe here. Relax, and please, enjoy yourselves.
Thank you. We appreciate it.
Why do demons avoid these towns?
You're travelers, right? How are other towns doing? Is the demon blight as bad as they say?
Demons are attacking cities all the world over, and the demon blight is spreading like wildfire! It's nuts!
That's terrible. Living in this town, I almost forgot about the demons. There hasn't been a case of demon blight here since the Advent. Nothing much has changed over the past 3 years.
Yeah. This town's the same as it's always been.
You've been here before?
Many times.
Really now? Wait, there is something that changed. The prickle boar meat.
The prickle boar meat?
Yep. It's gotten much easier to get your hands on high-quality, tasty meat. The hunters are probably able to do so well because they don't have to worry about demon attacks. Well, I hope you enjoy your return to Taliesin. Have fun!
A town without demons.
Could be there's a Therian at the Earth Pulse Point in Eastgand that's devouring the malevolence. What do you think?
That would certainly explain things.
Good day. How are you liking Taliesin? I bet you're surprised not to see any exorcists.
Yeah. I've never been to a town like this.
The exorcists stationed in Eastgand often leave to help deal with problems in other parts of the world. Then again, few are stationed here to begin with.
Are they on another of those expeditions now?
That's right. They're currently in Northgand, helping put down a group of dangerous demons. Even though they're gone, we still have regular exorcist patrols stop by. We feel safe enough with them. Maybe they should just move the capital to East Gand. Of course, I know there's no way that would happen.
I forgot today was the day Nico was coming. I missed out on buying that special quiche.
That's too bad. I wish she'd just open up a shop here. You'd think it would be easier than always having to make the long trek from a ball.
I heard she doesn't want to leave the village because she's waiting for her missing friend to return.
What are you talking about? A ball's nothing but a ruin.
What? Well, you're a morbid young woman. Sure, the place was hit pretty bad by a demon a few years ago, but it's not like it's abandoned.
Many of the villagers were hurt, but thanks to Lord Artorias, nearly all of them survived in the end.
That can't be...
It certainly is. In fact, there's a girl from there, Nico, who comes here once a week to sell things.
Just yesterday, my husband sent medicine to the general store there and got some juicy prickleboar meat in return.
That can't be right. With my own hand, I...
Velvet?
Velvet said a ball was wiped off the map, but it sounds like someone's been coming from there with things to sell. Do you think a new group of settlers moved in?
Apparently that merchant Nico is someone Velvet knows.
She said something about Artorias having saved the village. Do you think it had something to do with the Earth Pulse Point?
I can't say. We've heard too many conflicting things.
This feels wrong to me. Really, really wrong.
We won't find the truth by wandering blindly in the dark. The path forward is our only way.
Right. It's not like we can turn back.
But Miss Mogulu, what if there's darkness ahead too?
Then we'll take a nice nap together. Forever, probably.
Oh.
What's going on?
That's what I'd like to know.
That festival over in a ball sure was fun, wasn't it?
It sure was. What a cheerful and happy place. And the food was amazing. I'd love to go back sometime.
I loved the prickleboar meatballs. Nico's quiche was so good. It was a master quiche.
This Nico must be a great cook. I'd love to try this master quiche.
Where did you learn a joke like that?
Anyway, Taliesin's Fisherman Festival is coming up soon. We've got to show the folks from Abal a good time.
Yeah, I'm gonna help my uncle catch lots of tasty fish for the festival.
What do you think you'll catch?
Pickled mackerel, tuna rolls, oh, and duck stew.
Those are all the names of dishes, silly. And a duck isn't a fish, it's a bird. I swear, you don't think of anything but food.
Nico's... quiche.
Ask me what this town's known for. Answer, stairs.
Yeah, I've never seen this many stairs before in my life.
You're close to the sea, and the weather is beautiful and everything, but doesn't all this climbing make life here hard?
Not at all. I walked the stairs here since I was a child. A little climb like this is nothing. Everyone raised here has a strong set of legs and a sturdy back. You couldn't turn a profit selling back medicine here. No way, no how.
Just have to...
I wonder what Velvet's hometown is like.
A ball? I've heard about it from other sailors, although that was a long time ago. They said it's a fairly plain place, and it's home to rustic, hospitable folk.
Sounds like any country village to me.
I wonder if Velvet used to be rustic and hospitable.
Oh, you mean to say she's devious and rude now?
Not at all.
It's okay, you can admit it. It's pretty much the truth.
Well, I imagine she was a plain, hard-working girl. Hmm? You really believe that? Call it a guess, really.
I bet she was a cheerful, loving sister.
Maybe so.
And now she's the Lord of Calamity. If she sees her former friends, maybe she'll remember some of what she's lost.
But what has she lost?
Say, do you know why Velvet was sent to that prison island in the first place?
It had to be to funnel the other prisoners' malevolence to Anominot, right?
There's an Earth Pulse point near Abal, right? Wouldn't it have been easier just to leave her there?
Lack of food, probably. I heard she devoured the entire village.
Could that rumor really be true?
Who can say? Let's ask Aizen's coin.
You know it doesn't work like that.
All right, let's think. Why else would Artorias move Velvet to the island? If she was the first Therian he captured...
He needed a guinea pig to test out what was written in the ancient book.
Precisely. He made a special cage for her in the island prison, where Earth Pulse Point and Malevolence met. Then he used Velvet to test how Therians work.
I could see him doing that.
But turning his own family into an experiment.
I'm just offering a theory. But a man willing to sacrifice his brother's life wouldn't likely show mercy to his sister either.
How could he be capable of such things?
Perhaps that's just how badly he wants to save this world. Or perhaps there's no other way it could be saved.
Huh? Do you think there'll be ruins at this Earth Pulse Point, too?
If you're expecting something like the undersea or underground temples we saw before, you might be setting yourself up for a disappointment.
Have you been there before?
No. But if there's any such kind of grand structure here, it wasn't recorded in the Abbey's archives. Eastgand has long been a frontier, and civilization here was never really developed. Plus, the land to the east is said to be unstable, making it hard to build anything too large there.
Even if a temple had been built there, The shifting Earth would likely have swallowed it without a trace. The worship of Innominat may be widespread now, but just a few years ago, Empyrean faith was all but dead.
Right.
Still, if you actually searched for the ruins, I bet you could come up with something incredible. We've seen underwater and underground temples, so why not a temple in the sky?
A temple in the sky?
It's a romantic thought, and the ancients were certainly advanced, but...
Flying temples are a bit far-fetched, eh?
Hey, that's the beauty of magic. Anything could happen. A flying temple, a beautiful woman being sawed in half. The border between dream and reality is as fine as a frog's hair.
Maybe you just spend too much time daydreaming.
Maybe.